You might need a stiff drink after all those disgusting animals. What's the key ingredient, then, in the world's nastiest cocktail?
Malibu.
Creme de Oh!
Hey. Yeah. I reckon you've got someone a really good, quick type. It's just going...
We're after a nasty cocktail.
Is it a genuine drink?
It's a genuine cocktail that is served in a genuine bar in a genuine place in a genuine country.
There's one place.
There's one place, and it's probably...
Give us a clue?
It's a part of the body. We're in a country that is sort of known for its cleanliness, probably, more than anything else, and for its...
Japan. Switzerland.
Canada. Which they say of Toronto, it's New York run by the Swiss, so it's that kind of a place. But this is in the Yukon, in a mining bar, the downtown hotel of Dawson City. It's a part of a human being.
An eye?
Toenails.
Toenails is good enough.
Bogies.
It's a toe.
A toe.
A toe.
Toe. Yeah. The sour toe cocktail is the specialité de la maison in the downtown hotel.
Where do they get the toe?
Yeah.
Well, there's a whole story there.
Oh,
yeah. It started in the 1960s when a figure called Captain Dick Stevenson. He'd been all kinds of things, from a male stripper to a miner to a lumberjack, all the, you know, the way that manly men are.
Yeah.
Exactly. And he found himself in an old cabin, and there was a pickled toe that had belonged to a rum runner back in the Prohibition days. And for some reason, he thought it would be amusing to offer as a challenge to put it in alcohol, and the idea was you drank it. And it became a very popular drink. You kept the toe, though. It moved from glass to glass. But the important thing was, there's a little rhyme, which is the key, is you can drink it fast, you can drink it slow, but the lips have got to touch the toe. So the toe has to touch. But unfortunately, there was a series of accidents. In 1980, Gary Younger, a local miner, accidentally swallowed the toe. So they found another one, this very nice lady called Mrs. Lawrence of Alberta, whose middle toe was amputated due to an inoperable corn, donated it. So you were then drinking a toe that not only was amputated, but had a hideous corn on it. And people, that lasted well. It didn't have to be alcohol.
I've drunk worse than that. I remember being at a party once, no glasses, drinking tea and Maria out of a dog bowl. No glasses.
Wait.
That's chicken. It's fine.
So yeah, they've gone through a lot of toes. Now in fact they have a collection. People know about this bar, so they donate their toes if they're going to be amputated. So they have some packed in rock salt in the back. You can choose your toe to have with
you. Looks like he finds it hilarious. I can imagine going, hee hee, you're gonna have to drink the toe.
That's brilliant! You're gonna drink the toe! I love that!
It's only $5 a shot. They reckon 35,000 people have done it.
Yeah.
It's quite popular.
I mean, you're likely to pass on germs, though, aren't you? All those people touching the same toe seems very unsavory.
Yes.
Is a toe supposed to retain any flavour? Is it, has it been pickled in a way that makes the drink more interesting, or is it just for the...
I think it's just so you can say you've done it these days, isn't it? It's pretty, but it's leather now, I would imagine, isn't it?
Well,
leather and a hint of nail varnish. Anyway, there we are. Yeah, that's the downtown hotel in Dawson City in the Yukon, and it offers its patrons the sour toe cocktail, the liquor of your choice, garnished with a severed human toe.